قد ونستعين على صدرك ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن له لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه صلى الله عليه وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى صحابته الكرام ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله في السر والعلى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد Some of the Salaf, the early generation, once went to Aisha radiallahu anha and they asked her a question. And they narrate this incident to us. They asked her, what was the most wondrous thing that you saw from the Messenger of Allah? فبكت فبقالت كان كل أمره عجبا. She wept and she said, everything about him was amazing. But she gave one example. أتاني في ليلة التي يكون فيها عندي فاتجع بجنبي حتى مس جلدي جلدا. He came to me on one of my nights and he lay down next to me until my skin was touching his skin. فقلت يا رسول الله ثم قال and then he said after a while يا عائشة ألا تأذنين لي أن تعبد ربي عز وجل will you not give me permission to worship my Lord عز وجل فقلت يا رسول الله والله إني لا أحب قربك وأحب هواك أي أحب أن لا تفارقني وأحب ما يسرك مما تهوى She said, I love that you are close to me and I love that you do not part from me but I also love what you love
فقام إلى قربة من ماء في البيت فتوضأ ولم يكثر صب الماء
So he stood up, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he made wudu without using a lot of water.
ثم قام يصلي ويتهجد فبكى في صلاته حتى بل لحيته.
He got up, he began the prayer, he started to do qiyam, and he began to weep in his prayer until his beard became wet.
ثم سجد فبكى حتى بل الأرض.
Then he made sajda, and he wept until the ground underneath him was wet.
حتى and this continued إذا أتى بلال يؤذنه بصلاة الفجر
until بلال رضي الله عنه came to give the adhan for صلاة الفجر
رآه يبكي فقال يا رسول الله ما يبكي وقد غفر الله لك ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر
He saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in this state and he said What makes you weep when Allah has forgiven your previous sins and your future sins and the sins of the messengers and prophets are not like our sins But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم replied He said أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا Should I not be a grateful slave? Should I not be a grateful slave? Right? Gratitude. This is something we talk about a lot, but it may not be something we practice frequently. Allah says, وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِي الشَّكُورُ How few of my servants are grateful. Ramadan is a month of reviving this practice. When you come to Allah, عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ Allah says that one of the reasons of Ramadan is that so that you may glorify your Lord because of what He guided you to. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ Tashkuru, and so that you may be grateful. Now, derived from this shukr, you have two terms. You have shakir and you have shakur. Now, these are similar, but they're distinct. Shakir refers to someone who recognizes blessings. Someone who recognizes blessings. Shakur is someone who is grateful, who appreciates those blessings. And there's a beautiful story in the Quran in which both of these are demonstrated. Allah tells us the story of Sulaiman alayhi salam. We know Sulaiman was given a kingdom that no other man had been given. And Allah says that once he was walking, marching with his army, حَتَّى إِذَا أَتَوْ عَلَى وَادِ النَّمْلِ until he came to a valley of ants. قَالَتْ نَمْلَ One of the ants who recognized Sulaiman approaching said to the other ants, أَيُّهَا النَّمْلُ ادْخُلُوا مَسَاكِنَكُمْ لَا يَحْتِمَنَّكُمْ سُلَيْمَانَ وَجُنُودُهُ وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ He said, Go into your dwellings because Sulaiman and his army are going to trample you without realizing. Now pause for a second. What happens when one of us is reminded of an ability that we have? Maybe we're good at some sport. What happens when LeBron throws down a dunk? Right? What's his reaction after? Like, look at me. Look what I can do. And what happens when one of us sees we have a good profession and we see our name? Right? First name, last name, MD. First name, last name. Executive Vice President, Senior Engineer, First Name, Last Name, Chief Financial Officer. We feel good about ourselves. It's not necessarily pride, it's just a human, it's a natural thing. Right? Now back to the story of Sulaiman. Sulaiman is being made aware of two abilities that he has. One, is the fact that just by understanding what the ant is saying, he's being made cognizant of his ability to understand the language of ants. That's one. Secondly, what did the ant say? Look at the phrase. لا يحتمل لكم سليمان وجنوده. He said Sulaiman and his soldiers, Sulaiman and his army. What happens when media reports like one of these military maneuvers, like President so-and-so deploys troops to this region, or like Russia deploys warships here, or even if you read history, if you read history books, they'll say like in 70 AD, the year 70 AD, General Titus and his legions sacked Jerusalem. The way these things are phrased is to draw attention to the power that a particular individual or group has. And that's exactly what's happening with Sulaiman. And saying Sulaiman wa junudu, Sulaiman and his army, Sulaiman and his forces, right? Making Sulaiman aware of the izzah that he has. What's Sulaiman's reaction? فَتَبَسَّمَ ضَاحِكًا مِنْ طَوْلِهَا. He smiled, laughing from what the ayah was saying. وَقَالَ رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيَّ وَعَلَى وَلِدَيَّ. He said, Ya Allah, enable me to be grateful for the favors that you have bestowed upon me and my parents. وَأَنْ أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا تَرْضَاهُ وَأَدْخِلْنِي بِرَحْمَتِكَ فِي عِبَادِكَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And that you enable me to do good deeds that please you, and you enter me on the day of judgment into Jannah amongst your righteous servants. See, this is, he was shakir, he recognized the good, and shakur, he appreciated it. This is the way of the believer. One of the worst things about modern times is that ingratitude is cultivated inside people. They were grateful for education, they were grateful about food, they were grateful about parents, they were grateful about their kids, they were grateful about their job, they were grateful about security. Oh, safety. Oh, Muslims are so oppressed in the West. We have it so bad. Right? I mean, yes, there's Islamophobia. There are problems. We need to remain engaged. That's all a given. But there are these movements that are just predicated on just whining all the time. They're just victimization. And Allah warned us against this. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا. Allah strikes an example. فَرِيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً. A city, a town. That was amina, that was safe, mutma'inna, and it was tranquil. يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ. It got provision from everywhere, every place. فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ. But they were ungrateful for the favors of their Lord. فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. So Allah made them taste the envelopment of hunger and terror because of what they had earned. Beware of complaining, because if you complain, Allah will take your blessings away from you. And when He does, you're going to wish for the days you complain about. Rather, we should recognize the good that we have and ask Allah for better. This is the way of the mu'min. Right? The mu'min, the believer, doesn't do kufr bi an'amillah, because forgetting the blessings of Allah is essentially forgetting Allah Himself. There's this relationship between gratitude and knowing Allah. The person in tribulation, how does he know Allah? A person who's in a hardship, he knows Allah through sabr, tawakkul, right? Istamsaktu bil urwati al-wuthqa, by holding on to the firmest handhold that doesn't break. The person who's been given a lot though, a person in afia, in comfort, how does he or she know Allah? By attributing everything that he has to Allah, right? One of the scholars said something amazing. He said, if you understand, وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. If you understand that to Allah belongs everything in the heavens and the earth, you have understood Islam. If you have Allah and you attribute it all to Allah, you have understood this religion. And this is, it's a state that we're in. And when, it's a state of being, a state of mind, a state of heart. And when we're in this state, the rituals become meaningful. Like you can get in the car and you can just ritualistically, routinely say the dua safa. Or you can get in the car and your heart realize that this ability to travel is a blessing from your Lord. And this state of heart inspires your tongue to move with Subhanallah, Subhanallah. Glory be to Allah, attributing it to Allah. Allah who has subjected this vehicle to me. When you're done with the bathroom, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي أَثَبَ عَنِي الْأَذَى وَعَفَانِي. Praise be to Allah who has relieved this for me and given me comfort. After food, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي أَطْعَمَنَا وَسْقَانَا وَجَعَلَ مُسْلِمِينَ. Praise be to Allah who has given me food, drink, and made me a Muslim. Right? And once you're in this state, Allah gives you more to be grateful about. إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you're grateful, I will give you more to be grateful about. But unfortunately, the Muslims have lost this understanding of Islam. In fact, now, we complain about Islam. Islam is so restrictive. Everything is haram. Why can't we do anything? Not realizing the value of guidance. But Islam is the only religion that has guidance for each and every situation you can think of. Each situation that you're in. Right? I was once talking to someone, and this person, I hadn't seen him for a long time, so I said, how are you doing? What are you up to these days? So on and so forth. He said, I'm doing well. He said, I'm working, and I'm working at this company, and I'm actually doing the pre-dawn shift. Pre-dawn shift. And I said, wow, that's good, because it must be easy for you to wake up for Fajr then, right? He said, no, I stopped praying. And I said, why? Why did you stop praying? He said, something interesting. He said, I'm in love with someone, okay? And I just need this one person in my life, and then I'll start praying again, and I'll become a good Muslim. It's a tempting mindset to have, right? I just need this. I just need this one job, and I'll be a good person. I just need this from Allah, and I'll become religious. But this shows a flawed understanding. Why? To Allah belongs everything. But can you need the thawab of dunya? If you want something of the dunya, Allah has the dunya and the akhirah. Right? It's not we don't get to put conditions on Allah saying, yeah, Allah, do this for me, and then I'll do this. Rather, we submit to Allah in the circumstance that we're in, and then Allah helps us. It's a very profound metaphysical reality. Right? And this is the meaning behind some of the du'as that we've been taught. Like, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Where the Prophet said that whoever says this du'a and is in difficulty, his difficulty will be removed from him. What is La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin? Is it just a magic phrase that we say and everything becomes good? It's more than that. It's a mindset. What happens, and I'm sure every single person has this has happened to you, what happens when Allah seems to hold something from you? Right? You might start getting bad thoughts about Allah. What? I do this, I pray, I make dua, why is Allah holding, you know, this from me? Right? When you're in this state, this is when you say, La ilaha illa ant, there is no deity except you. Subhanak. Subhan is a negation of anything negative. So you're saying, Allah, you are above any bad thoughts. Inni kuntu min al-zalimin. I am the wrongdoer. Right? When you're in this mindset, this is when Allah's help comes. When you elevate Allah and lower yourself, this is where divine aid comes. Now, this is a gift. We have a formula to get us out of any situation. It's a gift from Allah. And as we start to understand Islam more, the more we'll see that this deen is a beautiful ni'mah from Allah that we should be grateful for and not complain about. We should say, رَضِيْتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا وَبِسَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَعَلَيْهُ وَسَلَمُ نَبِيًّا وَرَسُولًا. We are content with Allah as our Lord, with Islam as our religion, and with Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as our prophet and messenger. We ask Allah that He makes us among His constantly grateful servants. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا يوافي نعمه ويكافئ مزيده والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله. Whoever doesn't thank the people doesn't thank Allah. Whoever doesn't thank people doesn't thank Allah. As we increase in shukr to Allah, inshallah, we should also increase in gratitude towards people. And there's opportunities everywhere. You have, today was the last day of school, right here at Nur al-Iman School, where you have staff members and teachers in Ramadan with their own families to take care of, and they're coming and sacrificing and imparting their knowledge. They should be appreciated. You have the masjid volunteers. I've been to 3 masjid so far. Every masjid I go to, I think is better than the previous one. I come here, this is the best masjid. I go a few miles up north, this is the best masjid. I go somewhere else, but this is better than the previous two. And then I come back here, no, this is the best one. It's a testament to the incredible, the tremendous job that the volunteers are doing in making sure that we can come and worship our Lord in peace and comfort. We should be grateful to them. Because the hadith says that a person can think that he or she is grateful to Allah, but he's not, because he's ungrateful to people. And you can be ungrateful to people in the same way, the same manner in which you're ungrateful to Allah. How are we ungrateful to Allah? So one of the ways it happens is you've been given a lot of blessings, right? But there's one thing that's bothering you. Maybe you have a very good job, but the commute to your job is long. So what do? You focus on the commute is so long. My life is so bad. Do you know how early I have to get up every day? Right? I don't like doing this. You focus on the one negative, and that overshadows the blessing of having an income. This same way of ingratitude to Allah is the same way you can be ungrateful to people. You have a wonderful person, done a lot of good work, right? But you maybe disagree with him on one thing, or he makes a mistake in judgment somewhere, and oh, Allah, the person is so bad, doing all this, right? I was once at this Ustad Roman Ali Khan came to New Jersey a year ago, and it was run by youth, the whole event. So you have 4,000 people, this one event. It's something that's hard to run. It's not easy. Many of them, it was their first time. And it was a good event, alhamdulillah. But some things could be improved, like you're waiting in the cold for a long time. There was a little chaos. But what happened? You go to the Facebook page, the comments after. Oh, you guys are so bad. The youth don't know how to do anything. Why don't you guys learn from the non-Muslims? You guys can't put anything good together. Instead of saying, okay, you guys put together something great. Here are some small criticisms, which I'll help you with, inshallah. No, let's magnify people's shortcomings. Is this what we're taught to do? Did the Messenger of Allah say, Abu Bakr, you're too weak, and Umar, you're too harsh, and Uthman, you're too soft with people, and Ali, you're too much into this war and violence? Rather, he said, if the iman of the entire world was put on one, if the iman of the entire world was put on one scale, and the iman of Abu Bakr was put on the other scale, the iman of Abu Bakr would outweigh. And if there was a prophet after me, it would be Umar. And when they thought that Uthman was killed in Mecca, at Hudaybiyah, the Prophet took the pledge, he put one hand forward, and he put his other hand, he said, this hand is for Uthman. And about Ali, when they, during the Battle of Khaybar, when the Muslims were taking a long time to penetrate the fortresses, they couldn't do it, the Prophet said that tomorrow I will give this manner of leadership to someone who Allah loves, and he loves Allah. And it was Ali. And this is how, by honoring and appreciating his companions, that they became, went on to become the Khulafa al-Rashidi al-Mahdiin, the pioneers of the single greatest civilization in human history. So it comes down to two things. You have the sunnah of Iblis, which is ingratitude, complaining, blaming others, arrogance, right? And you're going to be put in situations in your life where you're going to be tempted to show arrogance towards Allah or towards His creation or both. But then you have the sunnah of Adam, which is humility, ظَنَمْنَا أَنْفُسَنَا, right? And this is why Adam is خَلِيفَةُ الْأَرْضِ and not Iblis. Adam was the one who truly knew Allah, even though Iblis lived for a much longer time than him. And this is one of the other beautiful things about Islam, is that you don't, to know Allah, you don't need to be a scholar, a alim, you don't need to be an expert in the Arabic language, right? Seeking knowledge is important, and it's actually fun. But the point is, the illiterate person can know Allah better than the scholar. And that's because knowledge of Allah comes down to one thing, mujahada. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Those who strive in our way, those who strive for our sake, we will guide them to our ways. And this mujahada is something that everyone can and must do to be successful. You could be a high school or college student. Maybe you have some issues. You got maybe sucked into the wrong crowd. Maybe you fell into a questionable relationship. Maybe you're up late at night watching where you're not supposed to be watching. These are issues that a lot of young people are facing. But if you know Allah, you will make mujahada. Ya Allah, I know you. إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ رَبِّي وَالْفَوَاحِشَ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ. You have forbidden immorality and lewdness, what is hidden and apparent. Right? I'm going to make mujahada and I'm going to avoid this. If shaitan gets the best of you, Ya Allah, I know you. You are Ghafir al-Dhanb and Qabil al-Tawb. You are the forgiver and the acceptor of repentance. Maybe you're with a group of people and you feel the urge to backway. Ya Allah, I know you. La yaghtab ba'dukum ba'da. You have forbidden this. I'm going to stay away. Maybe you're with some friends and they're all dropping four-letter words and you feel the urge to do the same thing. Ya Allah, I know you. Bisan ismul fusuq ba'da iman. How wretched is a transgressing word after faith. Right? And it's not just pushing, staying away from bad things. It's pushing yourself to do what's good. Right? Like charity. The Prophet ﷺ said, what's the best charity? He said, the best charity is the one in which you feel that you have little, and so because of this you feel miserly. This is the best charity to give. And right here we have the this masjid has $60,000 just in expenses just during Ramadan. Right? Opportunity. Mujahada. And we began by talking about shukr. You know who shows you his shukr when you make mujahada? Allah does. Inna hada kana lakum jaza'a wa kana sa'yukum mashkura. This is your reward, and Allah says that your struggle is mashkura. It's appreciated. That's literally what it means. And can you imagine what Allah's gratitude is? We get little doses in the dunya of Allah's reward. For example, it's June. Some of the younger people, you're on spring break now, or you might be on spring break soon. And this means that there's going to be a couple of months where there's going to be your close friends. You might not see them for a while, right? Then inshallah, September's going to roll around and you're going to see him again. What's the feeling you have when you're separated from someone close for a while, or when you're separated from a family member for a while, and then you see them all of a sudden, you run into them somewhere? It's a joy that we can't explain, right? Now imagine that you're in your grave. Allahu alam, how long? Thousands, millions of years. Then Allah destroys the universe, Allahu alam how long that's going to be. Then Allah recreates the universe and you're resurrected for Yawm al-Qiyamah. And we know Yawm al-Qiyamah is a long day. It's Yawm al-Thaqila, it's a heavy day. It's a day of stress and fear and anxiety. Right? Except for those who Allah, illa ma rahim rabbi. Right? But on Yawm al-Qiyamah, and then Allah judges you and judges that you have lived a life of La ilaha illallah. And then He enters you into paradise. Now, after all that time in the grave, right? On Yawm al-Qiyamah, all the anxiety. Now you see those people in the dunya who you were close to. Imagine how that's going to feel. But to get to that place, it takes mujahada, it takes work, it takes effort. The Messenger of Allah said, Al-kayyisu man dana nafsahu wa amila lima ba'da al-maut. The wise one is the one who disciplines himself and works for what is after death. Wal-ajizu man atba'a nafsahu hawaha thumma tamanna ala Allah. And the fool is the one who follows his desires and that has vain hopes, false hopes in Allah. Allahumma atina fi min adayt, wa atina fi min atayt, wa tawallana fi min tawallayt. Allahumma habbib ila al-iman, wa zayyin fi qulubina, wa karrih ilayna al-kufr wa al-fujur wa al-'isyan. Allahumma kun ma'a al-mustada'afin. Allahumma rafa' al-mustada'afin min al-muslimin. We ask Allah that He guide us. We ask Allah that He make faith beloved to us, that He make it beautiful in our hearts, and that He make fisk, transgression, disbelief, forbidden, detestable to us. We ask Allah that He elevate the rank of those who are weak. Amen. And we ask that Allah help those who are disenfranchised, and we, especially on this blessed day and this blessed month, we ask Allah that He make us a means of helping those who need help. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه يغفر لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون ويأخذ السلام.